The ransomware threat has now become more pervasive and dangerous than ever before. And attacks against small and medium enterprises in APAC have also increased, becoming bigger targets now than large MNCs. Which means all businesses, regardless of their size, can no longer think they're not a target. In our latest State of the Internet report titled Ransomware on the Move, we examine how ransomware has evolved so far, how it continues to escalate in the Asia-Pacific and Japan region, and what businesses can do to better protect themselves before, during, and after an attack. So, what's happening in the ransomware scene in APJ so far? Between the first quarters of 2022 and 2023, we observe a significant increase of over 200% in ransomware victims across APJ. That's higher than a 143% increase observed globally. And within the region, the most frequent ransomware targets were business services, manufacturing, retail, and constructions. Our security research uncovered two significant ransomware trends for the region. Firstly, ransomware attack groups are ramping up their operations in APJ. And we see this in larger, more organized groups like LockBit, which possesses the resources, expertise, and manpower needed to sustain launching attacks at such high frequency. LockBit is responsible for more than half of the ransomware victims in APJ and 39% of all victims worldwide last year. We saw an average of 50 victims around the world getting compromised each month, which means every day there's at least one organization falling victim to LockBit ransomware. LockBit even runs an affiliate program that invites other cybercriminals to conduct ransomware attacks using their variants in exchange for a share of the spoils. Secondly, we've observed spikes in ransomware activity whenever ransomware groups successfully exploit critical zero-day vulnerabilities. Our analysis showed that this strategy was most notably leveraged in the past year by another group called CLOP. CLOP took advantage of critical zero-day vulnerabilities in file transfer software. At first, they compromised Go Anywhere software users. Later, they used the same tactic against the MoveIt file transfer software users, both with alarmingly high rate of success. Through this, they were able to impact some very prominent companies and even government agencies. It's well known that ransomware is after one thing. Ransomware money. Because of this objective, our research found that ransomware attackers are choosing their victims in APJ based on the following five characteristics. Firstly, they now prefer SMEs or small and medium enterprises with revenues of $50 million and below. You might think that large organizations should be more attractive as targets because they can pay out higher ransoms, but our research tells a different story. In fact, more than 60% of global ransomware attacks now target smaller organizations, with APJ SMEs targeted at least three times more often than larger organizations. This is often due to more limited security capabilities, making them less able to fend off attacks and thus more likely to pay a ransom. Secondly, attackers prefer organizations operating in less regulated industries that are not legally prohibited from paying the ransom. Thirdly, attackers prefer organizations that stand to lose more from a successful attack than the ransom demanded. For example, manufacturers for whom delays could cost millions of dollars per day, or companies in finance and healthcare who could be fined more than the ransom amount due to regulatory violations if sensitive data is exposed. Fourthly, attackers target organizations with inadequate, limited, or outdated cybersecurity measures in place. And these often come from industries like manufacturing, which grapples with legacy systems that are difficult to secure, as well as healthcare, whose expanding medical IoT device networks create even larger attack surfaces. Lastly, attackers target organizations that have already suffered a ransomware attack. These victims are six times more likely to be attacked by a different group in the first 3 months after a successful attack. And we suspect this is partly because they might be more distracted or susceptible as they undergo post-attack recovery. Or they may have paid a ransom previously, signaling to the ransomware groups that they're worth targeting again. Ransomware continues to evolve as cyber criminals adapt to new cybersecurity defenses. Our report has revealed three ways in which ransomware attackers are evolving. Firstly, ransomware groups are now exploiting zero-day vulnerabilities in software vendors to conduct supply chain attacks that avoid the extra effort needed to enter and move laterally across victims' systems. These vendors are often storage or file transfer applications because they offer easier access to sensitive, high-value data. This change in attackers' tactics makes it harder to anticipate where will they attack next. Secondly, ransomware attackers now prefer to steal company data rather than encrypt it, because the traditional process of encryption is slow and can be detected, interrupted, or reversed, potentially leaving them empty-handed. In contrast, stealing data and threatening its exposure is more effective for extortion because exfiltrated data is irretrievable. The regulatory consequences of data exposure can also potentially be more severe than for revenue loss due to business disruption. Lastly, to increase the pressure on victims to pay a ransom, some ransomware groups employ additional tactics. And these may include threatening distributed denial of service attacks on top of ransomware demands. Furthermore, some attackers directly harass partners and customers whose personal data were compromised in the attack, adding another layer of coercion. So, what can organizations do to counter the threat of ransomware? Let's start with what needs to happen before any ransomware hits. In this phase, the priority is identification and prevention. Firstly, understand your attack surface and security posture by quickly identifying the gaps in your policies, security tooling, training, and processes. Secondly, implement security strategies such as zero trust network access and micro segmentation to ensure the majority of common attacks are prevented, allowing you to focus on just evasive and unknown threats. For these, you want to have policies in place that enable you to detect suspicious behaviors or indicators of compromise, otherwise known as IOCs, across the board and perform threat mitigation in the event of an attack. Lastly, you should implement regular security training for users and incident responders, conduct business continuity planning, or BCP, and crisis management drills, while ensuring you have in place an immutable backup strategy where backups are resilient from the ransomware attacks so as to facilitate rapid recovery. Now, let's talk about what to do to counter an active ransomware attack. At this point, your mission is detection and containment. You need to understand where you are in the ransomware kill chain and disrupt pivotal stages with multi-layered defenses in order to reduce risk and impact. The first pivotal stage is during initial access. Your goal here is to block attackers from gaining unauthorized access to your systems and data. Ensure credentials are protected via multi-factor authentication, or MFA, that uses the FIDO2 standard to safeguard from phishing attempts. Next, protect vulnerable web applications against attacks, including zero-day exploits, as seen in the CLOP attacks, by using a modern web application firewall, or WAF. Secure remote access for your employees and reduce unauthorized access by utilizing a cloud-based Zero Trust Network Access Solution, or ZTNA. The second pivotal stage is during command and control. As the ransomware attackers move deeper into the networks, they need to perform callbacks to the attackers to weaponize payloads and get further attack instructions. Consider solutions that allow you to inspect outgoing internet traffic, such as a DNS firewall, in order to block known command and control infrastructure and domains. These solutions must be able to monitor and block communications to malicious domains in real time. By stopping that communication from happening, you can reduce the likelihood of attack progression. The third pivotal stage, and arguably the most critical of all, is during lateral movement and privilege escalation. Now, the attackers will attempt to move laterally across systems and networks to spread the ransomware payload, causing massive harm to your organization by stealing and encrypting sensitive data. Consider implementing effective micro-segmentation solutions that not only restrict how critical workloads and devices communicate, but also stop any outbound communications with malicious internet destinations to greatly minimize potential spread and damage. The fourth and final pivotal stage is during data exfiltration and encryption. At this stage, you should try to minimize the impact and reach of the ransomware execution by stopping its spread to other data repositories if the attack is still ongoing. Consider implementing DNS query inspection to stop data exfiltration to known malicious sites or anonymous file sharing platforms. Ensure the security of your backups, as that's probably one of the biggest obstacles that stand in the way of the attackers getting paid. So expect them to be actively looking for and rendering your backups unusable. After successfully mitigating an attack, improve your incident response playbooks to further enhance your security posture and formalize the lessons learned. Now, let's discuss what to do in the unfortunate event of a successful ransomware attack. Your focus at this point should be recovery and communication. Here are some essential strategies to apply. First and foremost, it is never a good idea to pay the ransom, because there are no guarantees that paying the ransom will result in the safe recovery of your data, and it may actually mark you as a target for future attacks. Secondly, even while the attack is ongoing, you should start recovering business critical functions based on your assessment of where you currently are in the ransomware kill chain. And this is where your incident response training, BCP drills, and immutable backups implemented during normal business operations become critical. Lastly, communicate with all relevant stakeholders, including the authorities, as well as your customers that are impacted, if required. In some cases, having dedicated individuals to communicate with the attackers could be useful, especially when trying to buy more time for mitigating the threat or recovering the business. To conclude, we need to understand that today's ransomware landscape is far from the disorganized threats of the past. It has evolved into a dangerous, financially motivated, and highly organized underground cybercrime economy. To counter this evolving menace, your organization needs to stay informed while constantly implementing updated security solutions and continually reassessing and strengthening your overall security posture. For more details on bolstering your defenses against the evolving ransomware threat, you can download the full State of the Internet report linked in the description below. For more State of the Internet videos and other cybersecurity threat intelligence, be sure to like and subscribe to Akamai.